So you can see, nice wide shoulder. Just me, nobody else. And I just had a car come real close, yell out the side of their window, get the f*** off the road. Actually, action. All right, another training week is done. We are a little bit behind now. We have ironically been and done my half marathon in Queenstown, New Zealand, but we're just trying to catch up. We've just finished a run together.
Yeah,
it was a little pre-wrap up for our week leading into New Zealand. Yeah, I felt pretty good. I had finished my last long run, which you'll see. Felt amazing, like 12 weeks is done. Sorry, were you gonna say something?
No.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say something. 12 weeks is done, and yeah, Christo wanted me to touch on, you know, when I'd first started my training program to when I had finished. So I've been running for over 15 years now, and I hadn't really done much running since COVID, the odd run here and there, but I hadn't followed a structured training program since COVID had hit. So I'd started my 12-week program, and my 40-minute runs were around like 7:05 pace, and I think I just scraped in 5 kilometers in that 7 minutes. And by the end of my 12-week program,
and your heart rate was about 185 or something.
Yeah, like through the roof. My heart rate's still through the roof, but yeah, it was sitting at 185. Yeah, and then by the end of my 12-week program, my 40-minute runs were 6-minute pace or just under, and over 6 kilometers for the 40 minutes, and heart rate was sitting at around 170.
Yeah, but still, that's 15 beats a minute for a minute and a half quicker.
Yeah.
But that didn't happen straight away.
No, did it? That's what you wanted me to touch base on, was, you know, I didn't really see any improvement for the first 4 weeks of my program, and it was quite deflating thinking, you know, I used to run this fast and I used to be able to do that, and now I, you know, feeling frustrated just jogging along at 7 minute pace. And look, there's nothing wrong with 7 minute pace, it's just not the pace that I used to run at. But I've also had to take into consideration that I'm 15 years older than what I used to run at as well, so I haven't forgotten that. Mm-hmm. So, and then I didn't really start seeing progress till just around sort of the 5-6 week mark, and I started seeing a little bit, you know, faster pace, which was good to see. And then by the end of it was like, oh well, it was almost back to what I used to run at. So yeah, it feels good. We just finished a run together and it felt pretty good. Chris will go into his week, but overall I was really happy. I did a couple of easy rides in my week as well. Just keeping the heart rate in zone 2, which I successfully did.
You did, actually.
And that felt really good. I could ride all day at that heart rate and that power and that speed. It was really enjoyable, yeah. So, yeah, I'll pass you on to Chris and he can finish off his week.
Well, a couple of things in the week. I'll just go through my training stats. So it was about 400 Ks on the bike. I think that was about 12 and a half hours. Then I had 17 k's of swimming, which is probably one of my biggest weeks swimming. Included the open water swim and PTC, that was pretty good. Just did 2 k's pretty easy in the water, but I've only been in the open water 4 or 5 times now, so gonna do that a bit more just to get used to it, because it's a whole different feeling. I remember the first time I jumped in there was the first time I've ever swum.
And this was at the regatta, isn't
it? In the regatta, and I felt like I was doing somersaults. So I just want to avoid that feeling on race day. So I'm going to be doing a bunch more of those. I'll probably do them in conjunction with some of the shorter races. Whether I do the run or not, I might be able to now that I'm sort of back running, but not in this week. But I may just be doing them easy runs or something. We'll see how that goes. So anyway, that was that. I had my cortisone injection, which you'll see in the video. Look, wasn't as bad as I thought, the actual injection, despite having a 62.5 millimeter needle stuck into my hip. Yeah, look, he said, oh, I'll give you some anesthetic And I was like, oh, that's nice, before you put the giant needle in. No, I'll just put the giant needle in, and then the anesthetic goes in the giant needle. So that was pretty funny. They did it under CT scan, not under
ultrasound,
because they wanted to be more accurate. So yeah, look, that was good. The guy there was like frothing over my body fat. He was like, look at this scan, there's literally nothing. And I'm like, okay. And he goes, do you know what it is? And I said, oh, no, I've been tested, I think, as low as 11. He goes, oh, no, you'd be single-digit
body fat.
It's like, okay, sweet.
That was funny.
So, yeah, that was that. Another big revelation for the week that I'll probably go into a bit more once it starts to evolve, but I have changed coach. Yeah, just a bit of a, you know, different direction to my previous coach. Kelly actually mentioned his name and I looked him up, and then we had a quick chat, and it was pretty evident that he was going to be the guy to take me to Kona and beyond. So we really clicked, and have sort of really struggled with that since my cycling coach, Jesse Coyle. Just finding someone that really got me, and I've had a lot of coaches in a lot of different sports, and I really find that that athlete connection is
important.
Really important. Mm. So like, you've got to trust what they're saying is helping you in the best of you know, their ability, your ability. Mm. In order to buy into it. So yeah, I really feel like this is the guy. He he's messaging me at 9 o'clock at night with, you know, run analysis on my first run back, and you know,
good.
Yeah, it's going really well. So I'll go into that in some future videos. Maybe we'll get him on and have a chat. And yeah, so that's that. That's really what I've got. So
we'll wrap it up there, and you guys get to enjoy this last sort of final training week before we head into New Zealand, which was amazing. It was everything that I had wanted it to be, the event. And then yeah, Queenstown was just pretty spectacular. So we'll take you along that journey. But yeah, guys, don't forget, you have to like and subscribe. I know I say this every video, it's so annoying that we have to say this, but the more likes or comments or subscriptions we get, the more our channel gets seen and we can build it up for you guys to enjoy something. Don't forget, you can leave a comment, something that you want to see or don't see. It always helps us with the feedback. And yeah, we'll see you in New Zealand.
Ciao. That'll do. 3 hours. Yeah. What was it? Progressive. Done this workout a couple of times now where it's basically all aerobic but just getting harder. So first one was pretty easy, 225, about 255, 275, so, and yeah, apart from when I've turned the fan off now, heart rate stayed pretty much majority of the time under under 140 thereabouts, so yeah, pretty happy with that. This is the day, outside pools are closed, so 25 meter it is. Bit of lightning around, so in the indoor pool. Into love, the God, into fear, the flame, and to burn the crowd that has a name. And to right or wrong, and to meek or strong, it is known to scream it from the wall. I will, I won't, I will, I talk, I know.
So you can see, nice wide shoulder, just me, nobody else. And I just had a car come real close, yell out the side of their window, get the off the road. Actually, not even on the road. Nice wide shoulder. I just don't get it. I don't get it, why motorists want to be so bloody mean.
It's the way we say we make some dreams.
Jump in. Spotting duties today for the PTC open water swim. Chris is in the water, he's doing 2Ks this morning. And yeah, I'm just spotting. I just make sure all the swimmers get in and out of the water safely. Not a real nice morning, but getting that done. Here comes Chris. You can tell by his swim star. How was that?
Sorry?
I said, how was that?
Yeah, it was all right. Yeah. Not many feet to sit on. She's got the right idea.
Fins, flippers. I know. I could have jumped in and done it with my mine. How'd it feel all right?
Yeah, good. I was just concentrating on technique. Yep. So, yeah, pretty easy really. I did a dive in at the end and pick up.
Alright, Chris has done his open water swim. I'm dressed to go for a run. Got my scorcher. Love, love, love this stuff. Please jump on and grab some. I'll put a discount code as well. And now Chris is going to do a ride.
A grind?
Yep. Yeah. I'm going to go have some brunch. And he's going to ride up to the mountains. And I'm going to do a run and then I'll meet him up there.
Love you. Love you. I'll see you up there.
Be safe. Christ the cross, and to me the chair, I will sit and earn the ransom from up here. I will, I want, I will, I'm taught, I know, I've been every boy. Alright, run done. Another good run. My, I even got out the crop top. it's muggy. We had rain, storms. So it's so humid. Yeah, 40 minutes done with some effort. I did some 30 second efforts with an active recovery. I've been naughty and skipping some of my speed sessions only because I've been riding and on the days that I'm not running and the legs are a bit stiff and tender, but the body's getting used to it now because, you know, I'm 11 weeks into my training program. So, yeah, so I thought I'd do some efforts today. Felt really good. It was a sub 6 minute run for the 40 minutes. So pace is slowly coming back to what I used to run. And now, yeah, I'm so stoked to be back. Chris is riding up to the mountains. So we're gonna have some brekkie, so I'll meet him then. It's turning out to be a nice day.
Let's get a date day begin.
So Chris did his open water swim.
I did.
And then you rode up to the mountains, we're up at Working Falls, and I did my run. Now we've got a nice brekkie. Look at yours. And then a beautiful view.
And then an injection.
Bon appetit. Where are we, Chris?
I don't know, Synergy Medical Hub, I think, at Norwest.
And what's going on?
I'm getting a cortisone injection in my hip.
Nervous?
Yeah, a little bit. Never had one before, so.
Chris is not a fan of needles.
No, not needles that are, you know, 2 feet long either, so.
We'll keep you updated.
Done and dusted. It's okay. Actually not that bad. Like, he showed me the needle and it was like that big and I was like, and then he just jammed it on and I thought he'd put an anesthetic, but then the anesthetic goes down that needle. So he pushed that in fucking dry and yeah.
So if you're new to our channel, Chris has just had a cortisone injection into his hip because he had
an ileum postbursitis and damage to my hip tendon or something. So they've actually injected the hip tendon, not the bursitis, because the theory is that it shouldn't do that whole sort of area. Mm. So yeah,
fingers crossed it works and we'll see where we go.
Yeah.
Christ the cross into me the chair I will sit and earn the ransom from up here.
I just found this little guy. I think he's been injured. I just found him on the side of the road. Finally! You can hear his mates up in there crying. He's been hit. I've raised and handled birds my entire life, so I know what I'm doing. But he's not a happy little guy. But he got picked up. I'm back riding. My knee! I always get stuck with these bloody animals.
See that boy over there?
Yeah.
In the red shirt? No, you see that boy over there with the black pants?
A little bit busier today than during the week, so hopefully there's not too many footies thrown into a lane, but we'll see how we go. Just going to take it easy today. Had my injection yesterday, cortisone injection, and I said no exercise, but I mean, I'm gonna try and do what I can with either the pool boy or flippers or something. So, yeah. Just finished my swim. As I said before, took it pretty easy given that I had my cortisone injection yesterday. Did a bit of stuff with the pool boy, a bit of warm up and cool down with flippers. So trying to limit what I'm doing on my legs. Just something to get the body moving because I don't really, not that I don't like days off, I just prefer moving every day. I enjoy exercise, so yeah. And not totally sold on the idea of not being able to do anything for the day after the cortisone injection, more so because I'm not actually in any pain given that I've had 6 weeks off the exercise that caused the injury. So look, it could be, it couldn't be, so I'm taking it easy, but not off. Thank you.
to burn. A love that has a name. I will.
Long run is done. Just done an hour and 15. I got 12Ks in at 6:12 pace. And I'm all done for this training block. My half marathon at Queenstown in New Zealand is next weekend. Chris and I fly out on Friday. And I'm super stoked. A bit fatigued today. The legs were feeling it. I've pretty much done a workout 6 days this week, one rest day, and I'm really stoked with how my progress has come along. And it's not, these jacarandas are in full bloom and they're so beautiful. It's not gonna be a race because I just want to enjoy it and just run for the love of running. And Queenstown is absolutely spectacular to a place to run in. It's so picturesque and beautiful. So I'm looking forward to that. But I'm stoked my last one is done.